the phases of a construction project. It might seem simple or easy, but in addition to knowing what the phases are, what do we do? What are the key things to look out for? We're going to talk about that in this video. So what are the six phases? What are the keys to each phase? And what does it take to pull off those keys? So let's go. Phase number one, conception. In this phase, we're talking about establishing a vision for the project, which is so clear. And I'm not going to get too much into the details because there's a lot to this that deals with development, due diligence, permitting, conceptual design, right? But the key thing is the intent or the vision of the project must be translated to the design team, to the pre-construction team, and to the construction team clearly for this project to go well. And I will say that this is kind of a problem in our industry. It's not done very often unless you're part of an IPD project, an IPD light project, or a design build project. Very often, and I wish this would just go away, that's a design bid build contract delivery method, and by the time you get to building it, the people have completely forgotten about the original vision for the project. So any of those conceptual design documents, any of the original speeches, the teaming, the notes, the conditions of satisfaction, right? The vision for the owner for this phase must be cataloged, visualized, and preserved. Otherwise, the design team, the pre-con team, and the construction team are gonna lose that vision, and the vision will perish. Meaning, we'll start to make value engineering decisions, we'll start to cut corners, make changes, do material supplements, and ignore some of the things that our customer wants. And we can't do that. So phase number one is conception, like I said, our favorite part, but we have to bring that vision all the way through the other phases of a construction project. Number two, team and delivery selection. This is fantastic. And I will say, definitely never, ever, 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 ever do design, bid, build. It's just not a thing. I'm sure somebody on the other end of this video is like, well, Jason, this is appropriate. Why? Like, that doesn't make any sense. Like, it's a contract delivery method that completely disconnects the builders from the preparation, puts them into an emergency, and disconnects them from the vision like I talked about a minute ago. Just don't do it. I love me some CM at risk. I love, love, love design build. I love IPD light. And I love IPD, like let's integrated project delivery. I really, really enjoy these methods. And actually, in reference to IPD, I'm gonna tell you a secret at the end of this, which really just came about when I was creating this video outline that I think you're going to find remarkable. But the key points here is decide how you wanna contract your team and decide what team you want. Now, I will tell you, your interviewees are going to wow you with pictures. They're going to wow you with presentations, with pre-scripted speeches. They're going to come in with a really nice proposal that their marketing department gave you. I love it. I think that's great. I've done it before. At the end of the day, the only real way to win is to select a team that aligns with your core values, that you love and want to work with, that the darn contractor will actually give you without a bait and switch, and that you feel will elevate the experience of how you get there, right? Remember that most of the project well done is how we get there. It's not just we got there at any cost, right? You can really burn through a lot of people and deliver a product and really not be very proud about it at the end. It's how we get there, and how we get there is based on the team, and the team is selected in that process. So always know that you're gonna win when you have cultural fits, core value alignment, you know you like working with that team, you trust that team, and the contractor's not gonna bait and switch you. So in that phase, the key thing that you must remember is go ahead and find and lock in the right people, because remember, first two, then what? And there's another what, actually. Please like this video, please comment. I wanna hear your comments on, you know, hey, what are some of the things you wanna watch out for, or you think everyone else should watch out for in these different phases? I want to hear from you. I'll respond to you one-on-one. Number three, design. And I love me some design. Actually, let me just go ahead and speed up. Number four is the pre-construction process. So three and four, they're looked at as separate phases. For my experience in my career, they've either overlapped or always run concurrently. But either way, the design is greatly benefited by early trade partners, by contractor involvement, pre-construction efforts. And I personally have always aligned the pre-con with the design phases. Now, I know everybody doesn't follow these design phases, but I'm usually thinking conceptual design, schematic design, design development, and then when we're developing our CDs, right? Our construction documents, our construction drawings. And so I typically just from a high level will say that early on in the proposal conceptual design phase, I have a tax plan, procurement log, and I'm validating the budget. In schematic design, I have those same tools with contractor involvement and a lot of make-ready planning. In the design development phase, I, as the contractor, will work with the designer on constructability reviews, modeling, making sure that we are doing target value delivery methodologies, with choosing by advantages, with real-time feedback from our trade partners, with that kind of integrated partnering right early on. Really great stuff. At that same time, I will be onboarding the builders and developing the norm level tax plan, the zone maps, the logistics plan, the risk and opportunity register, the basis of schedule, and every other key tool that I need for the plan, and especially the procurement log. This you cannot go any farther past design development without really making sure that you have the long lead materials being coordinated. And then in the CD phase, I'll do my risk analysis, my fresh eyes meeting, make sure all of my deliverables are finalized, that the drawings actually have the constructability reviews, the modeling reviews, and conflict analysis all pulled in and a part of the final deliverable for the drawings and the specs, right? I'm gonna make sure all of that's coming together to where I have a remarkable plan, right? And so I look at those the same, but the key things to watch out for is do not have disconnected designers and builders. Do not have disconnected planners and builders. Integrate that team. The other thing that I would say is do not let those final drawings be issued if they haven't been coordinated and if they haven't had all of the constructability reviews updated. We need a good set of drawings. And I will say it's not a pipe dream. I have worked on projects where the designers pulled in all of our comments and we had a beautiful set of plans. So part of it could be, if you don't have a good set of plans, is that your phased design is too overlapped and too aggressive, or you might have a non-responsive designer, or you might have the wrong contract delivery method. But the bottom line is there are ways in CM at Risk, Design, Build, and IPD to get a good set of drawings. So don't leave that phase without having the integration among the team and that good set of drawings coordinated, ready to go. Number five, construction. This is one of everyone's, I think, favorite phases. We're breaking ground, we're out in the dirt, we're experiencing the weather, we're smelling concrete, we're hearing concrete pumps, we're smelling diesel. Just love this phase, right? What I want you to know, the key step to this phase is to turn your construction and all of that planning that you did into a production system using Tact, Last Planner, and Scrum. It has to be done, or else you will just, it'll be like Southwest Airlines boarding. It'll be like, hey, 1 through 30, go. You know, like, go figure it out. It'll be chaos. You'll burn through people. You'll lose money. What we need to do is take your planning and align it to lean construction planning principles, and specifically Tact, Last Planner, and Scrum. And if you do that, you will take bite-sized portions of your planning and implement those in bite-sized chunks on the project in a flow. And then close out, the one thing that I'll say is the team must be ready for it. Everyone must know that the end users will change things. We need a process to quickly respond to change orders, to quickly remobilize crews, to close things out, and to make sure there's full integration between the building maintenance teams and the construction teams doing the training, and that we don't just chuck it over the fence. We want to hand off and show somebody, just like they're buying a brand new BMW or like a Ferrari. You know, like, the level of care there is just phenomenal. Like, showing them every last detail. This is how you maintain it. I'll give you, for instance, like, if you go buy a boat, a brand new boat, they don't just say, here's your boat. They say, hey, let's go out to the lake. Here's how you start it. This is what to look out for. Here's how you fill up the ballast. They'll even show you how to surf sometimes. Like, they are in that sale in full integration, in full form, right? We need to do the same thing with our buildings. We don't just build it and chuck it over the wall and say, good luck. We need to hold the owner's and the end user's hand as we go through it. Do not make the mistake of not being ready for this process. So these are the six key phases of a construction project. And as I was going through the outline, I was like, oh my gosh, I'm so excited. Like, I'm seeing a pattern. You know, there's one word that I saw by way of pattern: integration. Integrated people, integrated teams, integrated communication, integrated systems, integrated everything, anything you can integrate. And it brought my mind back to a book called Integrating Project Delivery. Really every phase, right? From conception to team and delivery selection to design to pre-construction, construction, and to closeout. Like, what have I been talking about? Integrating the people, making sure we're all working as one team. It makes no sense to say, hey, we have these 100 people. We're gonna go do something great. Let's separate everyone out into different teams, build walls in between them, cut their communications, and contractually incentivize them to not talk to each other. That's insane. Would you ever do that in war? Would you ever do that in your own personal business? Would you ever try to win a football game like that? No, and I'd say hell no. Like, absolutely not, you wouldn't do that. So the key to this whole thing and all phases is integration. I really hope that you've enjoyed this video. I'm gonna link to you in the description below that book that I referenced, Integrating Project Delivery. Even if you skim through it, I promise you, it will open your mind to the concept or the fact that, you know, the component parts are important, but they only work if we're working as an integrated team. And so I hope you enjoy that book. Please read it, order it, and at least skim through it or cherry pick the sections that you want to read, because integration is the key to all of these phases. On we go.